of the water where quality is concerned. So we have to understand a certain terms here to represent the water quality. So we call sometimes the water with a term called wholesomeness or wholesome water. See, we have to understand that getting absolutely pure water in the nature is not at all possible, because absolutely pure water is the water which contains only 2 parts of hydrogen and 1 part of oxygen by volume, but nothing else. But when the water is found in the nature, it contains a number of impurities in varying amounts. For example, the rainwater, which is originally pure, also absorbs various gases, dust and other silt, organic and inorganic impurities while falling to the ground itself. Complete removal of these impurities becomes very costly, and also on the other hand, certain impurities cause the water tasteful, and our body also needs certain elements, and if present in the water, their removal is not necessary. Such a water which does not contain harmful impurities and does contain other salts and impurities, either they are good or unharmful to the health, is called as potable water or the wholesome water. So the wholesome water or the potable water is the water that does not contain any disease causing impurities, and it may contain the substances which, if present within their permitted limit, they will be either helpful for the physiological development of our body, or otherwise they should be unharmful. Such a water, it is called as the wholesome water or the potable water, and which is of even palatable, means accepted to the senses of the human tongue. Moving on to the next term, that is palatability. To be palatable, water must be significantly free from color, odor, taste, and of moderate temperature in summer as well as in winter, and it should be well aerated. So at least 4 human perceptions should respond to these qualities. Then only the water can be called as the palatable water. Palatability. Palatability is a term used to indicate the water that is accepted by the human beings when it is served to test the taste. Then the contaminated water is the one that contains the microorganisms, chemicals, either industrial or other waste, or even the sewage. When it is discharged into the water body, the fresh water may get contaminated, so that it will become unfit for its intended use. So the term sometimes polluted water is also synonymous with the contaminated water. They can be used interchangeably. So this contaminated water or polluted water, they can be interchangeably used. Students, with this we shall conclude this first video presentation of some of the topics under the module 2. In the coming classes, we shall discuss about the various impurities in the water. Thank you. I request all of you to view these slides and their contents, and also listen my lecture, and if you have any doubts, you can call me, and we can also interact in the Zoom application. I am going to inform you the time for this meeting. Thank you.